Have you ever wondered if those mosquitoes that are biting you in your backyard are potential vectors of disease? Well, today we're going to show you a DIY way that you can find out. My name is Rusty Lowe. I work with the Institute for Global Environmental Strategies in Arlington, Virginia, and I'm also a scientist with the Globe Observer team. So today we're going to do our DIY mosquito trap. I'm going to show you first the things we need to build it, and then we're going to build it. So first, you need a 2-liter soda bottle. The hardest part of this project is to drink the 2 liters of soda. Okay. The next thing we need is a pair of scissors to cut the bottle. You're gonna need a piece of sandpaper to rough up part of the bottle. You're gonna need a rubber band that's gonna hold the netting in place. You're gonna need some netting. And what I'm using here is a scrubby from the kitchen. It provides perfectly good netting. You could also, if you want, you could use the bag that potatoes or onions come in, or even some fabric from the fabric store, but not necessary. This works great. You also will want maybe some rocks from your yard, about a cup and a half of water, maybe some tape to hold it together, and if you're really fancy, an old stretchy sock, dark sock, but we'll get to that later. So let's start. You start with the bottle, you cut it in half. Since I can only do this in one take, I cut it for you because I tried to do it before and it made a huge mess. So what you just need to do though is you just need to cut it in half and you have the 2 pieces. Now, what we're trying to do when we build this trap is we are actually trying to psych out those mama mosquitoes. We want them to think that they have just found the perfect nursery for their babies. And in order to do that, we just have to have a little bit of understanding about mosquito ecology, right? Well, the cool thing about this trap is that it is a trap that is we're making it attractive for container breeding mosquitoes. Now, 2 of the most dangerous mosquitoes that are invasive that have come into the US recently are Aedes albopictus and Aedes aegypti. These are called the yellow fever mosquito and the Asian tiger mosquito. Both these mosquitoes are container breeding mosquitoes. And they also have a unique feature that other mosquitoes like the common house mosquito doesn't have, which is they don't put their eggs right on top of the water. What they do is they lay their eggs right next to the water. And this is a cool adaptation because it allows the mom mosquito to lay their eggs at any time, even during a drought. But then when it rains, the water in the container that where she's chosen to be the nursery will rise. It will wet the eggs that she's laid on the surface. They will fall into the water. And then she is gambling that there'll be water for 5 to 7 days for those mosquito eggs to mature into adults. So we're going to try and create that with this trap. So without further ado, the first thing we need to do is we need to take the top, the bottle side of the trap, and we need to rough it up right around the edge, right near the hole in the bottom. This is so the eggs, when she makes them, they will stick on the side. And she's looking for that. She doesn't want them to slide in the water right away. So we just rough it up real good. Doesn't take very long. You can see that now it's a little bit opaque there where I have roughed it up. Now comes the trap part. Okay, so we need to find our source of netting. Here it is right here. I'm just gonna cut off a piece that I can use like this. And then that piece of netting is gonna go right over the mouth of the bottle. And this is the real trap part of the mosquito trap. So by putting the netting right over the mouth of the jar here, what's going to happen is the eggs can go into the water, but the adult mosquitoes can't go out because the netting is keeping them from doing so. Okay, we're almost done. So now we need to provide the next thing that a mosquito mom is looking for, which is a watery habitat, which is nutritious and mosquito mom has sensors that lets her know there's water, lets her know there's certain kinds of chemicals in the water. Different mosquitoes like different things. I've been very successful using plain tap water. You can also use a little bit of fish food if you've got an aquarium in there. You can take a little bit of grass. You could take some pond water or stream water from a local source, put it in there. But basically what you want to do now is to put maybe a cup or a cup and a half of water in there. And if you want to put a little bit of a bait in there, you can. This is a trick that we learned from one of the libraries that are doing this with us in California. And they had problems with the trap blowing over. And so they suggested putting some rocks in. Well, why didn't I think of that? I'm a geologist, right? Well, okay, rocks. It's a great, great solution, okay? So we put the rocks in there. We have our water here. This is clear tap water, but like I say, it could be any, you can make it more nutritious if you want. And I'm gonna put in just about a cup and a half. It doesn't really matter how much it is, and it doesn't really matter where it goes, as long as the netting is above the water. You want to have it pretty close to the top of the water, but it doesn't have to be, you don't want it exactly touching. So I'm going to show you something like this. You can see it's just right above. Great. Okay. So what this means is, let's say you have your trap and you're all excited and you want to determine whether or not those bad mosquitoes, the Aedes albopictus and Aedes aegypti, are in your backyard. But then you get invited to go to the beach for 3 days and you forget about it. Well, it would not be good to have a mosquito trap that actually creates more vectors of disease, right? But you don't have to worry about this, because what happens is here is that once the mosquito eggs fall in the water and they mature into larvae, we want those larvae because we can identify them using the Globe Observer app, then they'll develop into pupa. And then if we don't do anything with them, they'll develop into adults. But see what happens. They have a place to swim around here. They're not swimming anymore. The place to fly around here, right? But they can't get out. And even if they find the opening, which they probably will not do, they're going to try and fly up. But even if they find the opening, they can't get through because there's netting there. So that is the trap part of this. So we have now created what we think is going to be a really attractive nursery for our mosquito moms. They're going to see that there's water there. There's a nice rough surface for her eggs. The last thing that we know from research that's been done is that the mosquito moms are looking for a safe place, a dark place. You're going to want to put your trap in the shade, because if it gets too hot, the mosquito larva will cook. You don't want to do that. You don't want to kill them like that. So put it in the shade. But also, the mosquito moms have optical sensors, and they are light sensors, and they're looking also for a nice, safe, dark place. So you can achieve that by just finding an old black sock. You could also use paint. You could use a piece of black paper that you tape. You could take some duct tape and tape around it and make it dark on the inside. But basically what you can do is just stretch that sock over your trap. Now this is a disaster. I'm afraid I'm going to spill the water on TV. That's going to not be very good, right? No, I was successful. Okay, so now you have, I would say, a very clever trick to get those mom mosquitoes, the mom container mosquitoes, to lay their eggs in your trap. So what I'm hoping you'll do is you will look for those larvae. They swim. They kind of swim. They're called wigglers because they swim in a wiggling fashion. They're long and thin. You'll recognize them as soon as you see them. Grab a few of those out of there. Take a look at them. Take a photograph. Send the data to us on the Globe Observer app, right? And then let us know what you find. There's a taxonomic key built right into the app, so you yourself can actually determine what kind of mosquito larva that you have. So thanks for building a trap with me, and I look forward to seeing your observations uploaded on Globe Observer. Thanks a lot.
This is my mosquito trap with the pond water in it. In the others, I put normal water, grass water, sugar water, and tap water as my control.
What I'm doing is I'm going to create five different traps, and I'm going to put them in five different locations. One of them at my house, one of them at my grandparents' house, and the other ones at other grandparents' houses as well, and possibly a friend's house.
So this is my trap right here. I'm just using a regular clear water and putting them in five different locations. One at my house, one beside a creek, one beside a park where there's no traffic, and two near a mountainside.
Basically the cup and container, and inside is that cardboard coffee thing, like the coffee slip. We put the net on top because we have a lot of lizards in our backyard and we don't want any lizards getting in and messing with the mosquitoes.
This is my trap. It's currently covered, but if I take off the piece of brown construction paper, it's just the 2-liter bottle trap. And this is the one I made with tap water. And then I'm doing one with pond water from an irrigation pond, lake water, river water, and water from a fountain.